Hey everyone, I was thinking about ChatGPT 5 lately since it first came out, and I was thinking it's really good at analyzing data. And I'm always on social media looking at trends, and X, or Twitter X, has trends on it. So I was thinking, how can I use those trends with ChatGPT? So I put these two together and I think the results came out pretty cool. It's an 8-step process. So in this video, I'm gonna show you all the steps that I did to get trends from X and use ChatGPT 5 to help me create t-shirt designs for print on demand, as well as the titles and descriptions and everything. So I'm using ChatGPT 5 as basically a personal assistant that's really good with data and can spit out a lot of things. So step one is going to X, and let's do that right now. All right, so here I am on X. This is step one. Go to X, go to the explore page first, and then here's the tab for trending. So trending right here. This trending feed changes multiple times a day. So you could do this in the morning and in the afternoon and at night if you want to do it. What I'm going to do is I'm going to click on here and just highlight all of it. There's actually 30 things trending right now, and this is going to be different than the one that I did that I'm going to show you, but the same action is required. So you just highlight everything and then hit Command C in your browser, so you're copying the whole thing. So now this is on your clipboard, all the trending stuff for today, or for this snapshot of time that you're doing it. It's, like I said, it's going to change multiple times a day. So that's step one. Go to X, trending, select all trending, and hit Command C or copy it. So step two is to go to ChatGPT here, 5. You can see I did it already. I have this prompt right here. I have a list of what's trending on X right now. Can you scan it and figure out what t-shirt ideas I could create that matches one or more of the things on the list? Make sure that I don't have any copyright or trademark issues as well. So you can write any prompt. That's just a very simple prompt. There are probably other things you could put in there to make it better. But I'll make sure to put this prompt as well as all the steps in a digital download on my page. So you can either type this out for yourselves or get the digital download and copy and paste it. So once you have this, then you'll paste all the trends right here. So I'm going to show you how to do it. On here, I'll start a new chat. I'm gonna copy and paste. Well, first I need to copy and paste the prompt. So let me do that here, like that. And then I'm gonna copy and paste. Well, I'll put some spaces in between, boom, 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 like that. And then I'm gonna copy and paste this, which isn't on my clipboard anymore because I copied and pasted something else. So let's do this again. Just scroll it all the way down, copy, Command C, come here, Command V in here, paste, and there we go. And then I'll just hit run. And so now ChatGPT is looking at all of them. This is a new list and it's gonna do its thing. Whoa, it already did its thing. So here's some ideas that it came up with. So in real time, it's doing it right here. And you know, not all of these are gonna be winners, but it gave me 7. I could have put in the prompt, give me 10 or give me whatever, however many you want on here. It gave me 7 on here. The next step, so that's step two. Step three is to make prompts for these. So here's another prompt that I'm gonna tell you, and this is having ChatGPT write prompts for these prompts. So let me show you what I mean. I'm gonna hit Command C. I'm gonna put this right here. I'm saying, can you write me prompts for these ideas that I could post on Ideogram to make t-shirt designs on a solid black background? So now that it has ideas, I'm gonna use ChatGPT to write prompts so that it makes images. Now, I could ask it to make images here in ChatGPT. I just don't think it does text very well. Even still, I think Ideogram is better. Mystic is better than ChatGPT. So I'm gonna have it write prompts for me and then put that into Ideogram or Mystic or whatever your favorite one is. If you wanna do it here in ChatGPT, you could say write prompts for me and then have it create designs with those prompts as well. But this is the very next step, write prompts. So I'm gonna hit this and you're gonna see what ChatGPT is doing. It's actually writing a prompt for what to design for. So you can come in here now and just copy and paste these into your favorite AI app, whether it's Kittle or Ideogram or whatever. So I'm gonna show you what I did. I did this beforehand with my other ones, and it's not gonna be exactly these, but it's gonna be, and let me go back to the one that I did. So these are the ones that it wrote me earlier. You can see seven, some of the same ones, and it wrote me these prompts right here. So this one actually did a copy paste. I could do that. So I'm gonna hit this copy right here, and I'm gonna go into Ideogram and show you what it came up with. So I'm here on Ideogram, and just to show you how easy it is to put it in here, I'm gonna copy one of the ones that it did. So I'm gonna hit copy like this, and on Ideogram, you can hit Command V again. And in this case, it wrote me 4,500 by 5,400. I don't think it needs that. So I'm gonna do on here, so on a solid black background like that. Now, you can do public one by one if you want it different size. Maybe you want it 2 by 3. That's totally cool. You can come in here and do it. By default, Ideogram does 4. So I'm gonna hit generate just so you can see what it did. But if we come back here, you can see that I actually did all of these. So this was the first one that it did, and did this one and so on. And this is the one we're doing right now. So it's kind of a cool cat there. So next step is to take these and get them ready for PNGs, or make sure that they're the right size and everything. All right, so I'm here on dgb.lol. It's absolutely free to use. Depending on what app you came from, you can click on here, drag in your things, your PNG files that are usually 1024 by 1024 or something similar, and it will upscale it. So let me pull one in so you can see. So here's one, I'll drag it in here. You can see that was one of them. I'm gonna pick one of these and hit 6 like that, and hit submit. Now I'm not gonna hit submit because I already did this one, but let me show you what it comes up with. So once it's done, it's all here, and when I download it, now it's 6 times, so it's definitely big enough. All I have to do is remove the background. So now that this one's ready, I didn't download these yet, so I'm gonna download this one. This good morning here is gonna be the right size. You can see it's downloading. It's gonna say 6x, so I'm gonna bring this into Photo P to remove the background. All right, so I'm here on Photo P. I'm just grabbing that design, dragging it in here. You can see that it's, well, you can't see that it's a big size, but we'll see how big it is a little later. First thing I wanna do is remove the background. I'm gonna go to select. Instead of remove background, I'm going to color range. I'm gonna click on that. And then I'm gonna make sure to slide this so then it looks more smooth, like all the white. Yeah, there we go, that's a good one. And actually we want it still to be black on some of these here, but the background needs to be solid. Yeah, that's a good one. There we go. And then I'm gonna just hit backspace or delete. There you go. Hit Command D to get rid of those marching ants or those dashed lines. So next thing you wanna do is go to image, hit canvas size, make sure not to have this relative on. We do 4,500 by 5,400, boom. And then it's 5 by 6, and then you hit okay. Make sure to have your transform controls on here, and then you can size it down. There we go, that's a nice size right there. All right, once you're done, you can click File, Export, PNG, and name this whatever you want, Good Wednesday, and make sure to, it's PNG 4,500 by 5,400, and hit Save. Now that it's ready for PNG, we can go into any of our print-on-demand sites. I'm gonna go to Amazon, and we're gonna upload it. All right, so here we are on Amazon. I'm gonna take that one that we just did here from Photo P, the PNG that I saved. Let's see how it looks like. Now, of course, this is not made for a dark one. We could have put white in there, but let's see what it looks like on a white one. Right there, right? Now, if I came back and I wanted to put white in the background, it probably would work on better, more shirts. So we could do that as well, but I just wanna show you that it's the right size. Here, look at that, that looks really cool. As far as titles and description, we can also use ChatGPT for that. So I asked it right here, I will also need titles and descriptions for this on Amazon. Can you write them? ChatGPT wrote them. So let's see the Good Wednesday. Here it is, Good Wednesday. It wrote it for all of them. I'm gonna do Command-C again. Come in here, Command-V, boom. Hit, go back here, hit the description, Command-C, and Command-V. That is it. Well, it probably has the word t-shirt, so make sure to take that out. It doesn't like that. And it's probably in here too. Right there, shirt. Sometimes ChatGPT thinks that it can write shirt in there. Make sure to write that. Now your brand would be whatever. You can do detour shirts. Well, I can do detour shirts. You can put your brand in there, or you can put other words in here from here, like keywords. So you could put Good Wednesday as well, vintage, groovy, all those things, and do that, as well as some of the other ones that were in here as well. So whether you want to do that or not, and you can have it write more bullets too. So actually, this was supposed to be in the description. I'm going to take this out and put it here. So it wrote a description. You can ask it to write featured bullets, brands with keywords, and all of that. I didn't do that, but take a look at how this turned out. I went from concept and in only a few steps with ChatGPT and Twitter getting a trend for this. I think this is a trend that comes on all the time. Good Wednesday, I think people love that as well. So there's a bunch of them. I just do this over and over, and I think it's a great way to try and capitalize on the trends that X has already. So there you go. Those are all the steps that you need. I'll put all the steps in a big pamphlet right here in a digital download, and you can see it. If I went too fast, you can go back and look at those. It has all the prompts that I used as well. So use that. I think this is a really good method to get some ideas out there, especially ones that are trending right now. It's a good way to get ahead of them. You can get designs really quickly and put them up on print on demand. That's one of the powers of print on demand, is that you can actually create something that's trending right now. You can be ahead of the game, whereas for those big box stores, they actually have to wait like a month or two, and sometimes the trend is gone. So you can jump on trends that really quickly this way. If you want to use ChatGPT for other things, I made this video right here on how it's helping me gamify my schedule and doing things with print on demand. That's a really fun idea too. ChatGPT can do a ton of different things. Look forward in the future. I'm gonna try other things with ChatGPT as well. Thanks again for watching. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.